tell the benefit lah, macam mana apa ni, Japanese punya benefit lah. Sebab the method of Japanese punya university biasanya, setahun sebelum graduate tu memang dah kena cari kerja. Maksudnya dia orang dah secure job.
Okay.
Before graduate, okay. So itu yang saya try to apa ni. Tapi bila some stage dia orang dah masuk company, sebab the reason why dia masuk company company at first stage, sebab itulah, sebab memang Japanese punya culture tu sebelum setahun sebelum graduate memang akan secure job, cari kerja semua kan. Okay, itu the reason lah. But bila dah balik Malaysia semua, okay, certain time dia dah kerja, they don't feel that this something they need to go further lah for to remain the Japanese organization. So historical, actually saya bring the historical of Lucas policy lah. First reason why kita hantar banyak orang untuk study kat Jepun at that time. Attract investment to come to Malaysia. Okay. Same thing lah. Cakap after sometimes they have low job satisfaction lah, most Malaysian yang graduate. Ini saya tak ambil cerita. Okay. So ni Japanese job satisfaction in Malaysia lah. This basically overall lah, not focus on Japanese graduate only. So mainly actually they actually so, kita punya Malaysia actually kita retirement age 55 lah. Dululah, even sekarang pun rasa still lebih kurang dengan KSP, walaupun kita sekarang ni dah, kalau government ada sampai 60
even. Yeah. Okay.
So itu sebab, antara sebab actually in term of promotion semua memang kita, maksudnya dah some stage lah, macam tak boleh pergi lagi. Sebab kita memang, kalau kita pergi tu, dia continue, people list almost retired. So they leave the company. Japan also don't see the benefit. So ni pula kita nak fokus pada apa panggil, practice, hiring practice, pay scale dan benefit macam medical benefit, everything and promotion in Japanese company. Extend dia orang punya kerja je.
Itu satu lah. Itu one of the ways. Tapi kalau you nak extend dia punya apa work tu, apa yang nak extend? Ni lah, hiring practices. Dari segi apa hiring practices yang kita you can actually explore? What are the things that you want to find out kan? Basically, you want to find out. What do you want to find out? What do you actually want to find out? Apa? Okay.
Sebab ini masa dia buat mana panggil dia punya panggil survey tu, dia fokus pada dia fokus pada orang yang baru graduate in Malaysia.
Okay.
Dan
New graduate, okay. But now you are trying to also look at mid career, right? So mid career, mid careers, engineers or professionals yang switching to non Japanese companies kan? Yeah. Betul tak? So that is yang you want to find out kan? Probably one of the thing that you want to do. Not only why, tapi comparison kan, you want to compare dia punya human resource practices between Japanese and non-Japanese. So benda-benda tu yang you kena, mungkin you kena explain benda tu lah. yang ke dalam sikitlah. Ini surface entah dia tak ada service management style kan. Apa karakteristik dia? Can you go in more detail? Can you go in more detail and explain the management style macam mana kan? Okay. Aha, okay.
Nah, ini dia. Okay, so sekarang saya cuba nak extend dia punya paper ni. More focus on because okay, sebab tu yang saya bawa tadi pasal kenapa look is policy. The purpose of look is policy actually just to the purpose untuk belajar daripada Jepun, study what kind of Jepun, then try to copy the idea how Japanese can grow in very quick after World War kan. Okay, tu yang kita nak fokus buat Japanese graduate. Setelah government hantar sana, bila balik, okay, dia memang kerja Japanese company untuk try to adapt and then, tapi at the same stage, they don't see there's a need to go further lah. They move to another company, don't want to copy the to practice what kind of Japanese do.
Okay. So you what are you going to do? Oh, what is the okay lah? Apa problem dia lah? I mean the problem statement. Kalau cakap currently, what new graduates and the other formid career? Okay, our final were largely consistent with insights. What does it mean? Apa yang dijumpa ni? Were largely consistent with the insight from literature on Japanese style management.
Okay, sekarang ni finding dia lah, finding yang paper ni. Yeah. Mainly cakap both actually satisfied to happy lah with the Japanese company working with Japanese. But in reality actually even Japanese graduate yang itu, they actually not really happy to work with Japanese company.
Mana so dia, mana finding dia? Mana dia punya?
Itu yang saya punya nak extend tu.
So you don't know. You cannot draw conclusion sekarang. You cannot conclude that people are not satisfied because there is no data.
Okay.
There is no data to show that company people are not satisfied. Understand? So you cannot just say I'm going to prove people not satisfied because you don't know. Unless you get data, then only you can say, oh, betul, people are not satisfied. You understand or not? So this is what research is all about. Now, research is about is not making conclusion. You don't make conclusions now. Okay. You do not make, you don't make assumptions lah. Kita tak boleh buat assumption. Kita kata ini pasal dia bosan dengan syarikat Jepun. Mana you tahu? Mana buktinya? Mana datanya? So I want to find out whether the reasons. Okay, I want to know what are the reasons for switching, contohnya. So from that reason, then only I can draw my conclusions. Nampak tak? So this ni macam ni dia ada, dia mesti ada dah. You want to maybe replicate yang dia buat ni. So dia punya replicate maknanya who wants to work for Japanese companies ataupun who wants to continue working. Tu dua benda lain eh. Tu dua perkara yang lain. Yang ni adalah kalau saya nak benda ni new graduates. Of course dia buat juga lah mid career kan eh? Tapi I want to reprove it again. I want to explore again. Is it true now? This pasal survey ni snapshot in time eh? Dia hanya buat pada masa survey tu dilaksanakan. Survey dia bukan sampai bila-bila dia kekal eh? Itu kena faham lah survey punya apa ni result eh? Dia change. So you want probably to ask yourself whether what are the reasons? Apakah sebab-sebab yang menyebabkan dia tidak terus bekerja? What are the reasons? Or maybe you want to know not only the reasons. Reasons is one thing, but you want to probe in why. Itu why ni you kena buat case study lah pasal kalau survey ni ia tidak pergi kepada, you know, very difficult questions. That's why you can try to go for continuity maknanya the continue working with the organization, then you can see then you can conclude lah. Maknanya sekarang ni after the result that we found out that yes, my hypothesis, now you're having a hypothesis, your hypothesis is many Japanese graduates dia rasa apa ni tak ada peluang nak naik pangkat. Tapi mungkin dia dah dapatlah some finding kan from other studies, but you want to try and reaffirm it again. Reaffirm maknanya kita want to prove it again lah, ataupun reconfirm lah basically. Nampak? What else dan apa ni?
Macam apa? Case study ni. Sample, tapi sample tu dah masuk chapter ketiga kan.
Sample ada metodologi.
Ya, maksudnya sample cukup ke dalam dua sample?
Kena check dalam buku Yin lah. Buku Yin ataupun some. Dah tak. Kena check some apa ni.
So, macam Prof cakap itu, yang macam Prof punya buat PhD tu, Prof pergi gunakan survey kan?
Survey saya tu buat dua-dua sekali. Saya buat survey.
Oh, dua-dua ni.
Saya buat dua-dua method apa ni, survey dan juga case study. Case study of boleh check dalam ni lah, dalam apa ni. Previous studies lah, previous studies that apa ni that have been done by other apa ni other researchers lah. Ha? Kalau dua ni dia macam sikit lah, macam sikit. Yang kamu nampak?
Nampak.
Okay. So ini adalah a case study of just job satisfaction in an offshore office. Is software engineer's motivation at risk? Adakah motivasi software engineers at risk? Right. Okay, tak apalah, dia ada dua citation. Saya just so the case study of job satisfaction in an offshore office. Dan kalau kita tengok sini, satisfaction kan dia nak tanya sama ada dia happy with the job, okay. So motivation and job satisfaction are commonly referred as soft factors, which are difficult to dapat, boleh baca kan? Dia nampak kan? Tak apa kan? Saya nak tunjukkan ni, okay. Nampak design of study apa? Yeah. Objective and research questions. What motivate employees of the job? Are there threats to job satisfaction? Saya email kamu lah ni. Saya email just for you to have an idea kan. Ini case background. It is a medium-sized subsidiary. Okay, dia buat satu company lah. Apalah ni dia memang pilih one company. Lepas tu dia okay, the survey was based on rigorous literature analysis. Comprise two type of closed question inquiring about project setting and software. Maknanya dia bagi soalan orang ni closed question, dia soalan tertutup lah eh. Dia ada 6 dah respons company tu. Okay, just one company. You can just go to one company and you know, katalah Japanese company satu, American company satu, dapatlah engineer-engineer yang ni. Tak payah nak, maknanya dia tak semestinya. Kamu fikir mesti Japanese train mesti ini kan. Jadi dia jadi quite limited lah. Okay. So Jadi dia summarizekan lah what motivate employees. Dia jadikan sebagai, saya ingat dia macam macam survey sikit lah. This is case study yang lebih mirip kepada survey. Eh? So dia tanya what motivate employees, influence and so on, challenging work. Lepas tu, are there any threats to job certification? Ha, ni, opportunity to get promotion. Sama lah kamu cakap pasal pekerja dekat Jepun, hilang Jepun, sama je semua company. Personal growth, okay, above the average and free benefit, slightly factory. At the same time, careful attention should also be paid to factors that were selected as neutral, since it is fair to... Okay. Ini the case study in one company lah. So you can also use one company, katalah you minat one Japanese ni kan. So you can do the study lah, employee satisfaction. Employee satisfaction, pasal dia dia berkaitan dengan employee satisfaction. Okay, so ni interview question dia. What do you think are the reason that employees with a low income, ni low income lah, you tak nak lah. You boleh pilih soalan, tapi you kena buat reference lah. You kena quotation, citation, you kena bagi lah kan.
Oh yeah.
Bahawa you ambil soalan ni daripada author ni, soalan ni daripada author ni, soalan ni daripada author ni. Lepas tu you combine kan, jadi you punya questionnaire kan, ataupun case study question kamu. So dia dah chapter 3 lah memang, dia ke arah chapter 3. Tapi nak dapatkan dia punya problem tu, dia sekali lah, dia kata dia apa problem kita, lepas tu bagaimana nak dapat data. Pasal kita akan sentiasa tanya soalan lah, betul lah soalan kamu, berapa case tadi nak buat, berapa orang. Tu memang akan selalu kita fikirkan. Tapi senang tak lu, bukan senang, it is best that we go back to the literature, that we go back to the journal to check if it is relevant. If you read the journal, you don't have to read everything of the journal. You just read, rush through lah, tengok. Speed reading kan, tengok, oh ni, ini relevant. Nampak? Eh? So that is skill lah, ni kemahiran yang kena belajar lah, kena apa? Kena timba lah. There's no other way. Saya tak boleh serahkan semua nak buat untuk you, I cannot. Because I'm training you so that you think like a researcher. Okay? So you can actually, jangan saya nak. Okay, saya kena, dia download ni. Okay, dia download ni. Jadi saya cari balik. But what I'm saying is that, you know, by, of course lah, saya, because I have, saya have an ample experience, so I said Google sekali. Kenapa dia tak ikut? You tahu apa jawapan dia? You tak tahu kan? Antara jawapan mungkin you agak-agak lah. You agak-agak, kan? Agak-agak berdasarkan, depend on your experience. So now, can we put that into an academic study? Then that's the whole thing, you know. You may have the experience and also the tacit knowledge, you know. Tapi, is it true? How to prove that your hypothesis or your guess, apa ni, your opinion is right or wrong? Unless we do a study. So, a scientific study to prove that Japanese trained engineers, Malaysian, who go to Japan and come back as engineers, will change job. Okay, so our hypothesis is they will not be, there is no lifelong employment among Japanese engineers, trained engineers. So your hypothesis is, I want to prove that there is no lifelong employment attitude. This is attitude, kan? This is belief system. Jadi kita boleh, what do you call, macam ni lah, ni boleh download ni, apa, what can we learn from Japanese? This is lifetime employment contest learning. So this can become the basis for yang tadi sebut tadi lah, Japanese management system. So you put that Japanese management system later on into the set of questioning. Do you practice lifelong employment? How many jobs have you? Jadi dia jadi macam satu dia akan menjawab soalan kita nanti. By getting the answers, you will know how many percent actually believe in lifelong employment. For example, if you survey, ini kena buat survey lah. Kita boleh buat. Kalau buat case study tu, you kena tanya dia why you dah pilih orang yang apa ni, they have these characteristics that they already switch job. Then you want to ask them why they switch job. And then that one probably you need. I don't think two is enough. Kalau you want to detail case study, maybe 4 or 5 is enough. Maybe 4 or 5 is enough. Quite many lah. But two, dia risky lah. Risky lah. Dua ni, macam saya tanya soalan lah. Apa ni, siapa nak jadi Perdana Menteri? Tanya kat dua orang. Ya. Tak boleh. Tak boleh. Okay.
Sebab hipotesis saya actually gini. Sebab kat Malaysia banyak option. Itu je. Sebab Malaysia not only Japanese company, ada American company, whatever Europe company kan. Tapi in Japan, even memang ada investment untuk Europe company semua. Tapi the working culture is like that. So walaupun ada banyak-banyak company tu, dia orang tak move. Tak move eh.
Tapi that is... You have to rethink that. So you are saying that because there are many different types of different companies, different types of companies, American, Malaysian, European, choice lah, choice. Because of the choice, so we call it choice. So you kena generalize sikit lah, generalize sikit. We are spoiled for choices. Kita ni spoiled for choices. So we are because of the choices. But you must understand. Okay, what's the difference between these choices? This is coming back to HRM, kan? Human Resource Management System, pay system, working culture, management culture. So you need to do comparison. So your job now, as a literature review, is to compare management practices in terms of working style, leader style between Japanese, American and Malaysian lah, contohnya lah, ataupun European ke, you choose lah, you choose.
Okay.
Japanese and Western. Maksud kita ni banyak Western, Malaysian ni banyak Western actually. Malaysian ni kita British lah, kita kata kita British. Kita bukan Japanese, kita banyak British. So it is actually Japanese way of doing things versus Western way of doing things. So you have to look at the punya apa ni differences lah, okay? The differences between Japanese and Western management style. Japanese, you can look at Japanese and Western management style to simplify things lah. Kita kata Malaysia ni kita pun adopt from British, therefore kita kata apa ni, it is two different way of doing things lah. Bukan kata dua-dua yang ni salah, yang ni betul, tak. Tak ada. Dua-dua ni ada positif masing-masing. Okay. So the basic difference between Japanese and Western employees is the connecting. Saya suka Jepun kerana dia ni dia apa? Dia apa orang kata lebih kepada Eastern lah, Eastern. Itu kalau Western macam kita bincang last week lah, like we discuss American dia, I don't care how you do it, you just do it.
Okay.
Dia result oriented. Results oriented dia. So it is, there is some question lah. So should, some people they like it. They like, they want result driven. Dia tak suka process kan. Sometimes process is also important. Ha, jadi orang tipu, potong, shut, got shortcut, dapat result.
Dapat result. So, nak buat balik boleh.
So, mana yang actually lebih apa ni, I mean it depend on the person punya belief system, jiwa dia lah. Jiwa dia. So, you can read this and see whether it is actually difference apa ni, different value system kan. Japanese investment management approaches, tapi ni lama ni. Tengok ni. Saya kalau kamu ajak saya bincang, saya ingat sampai malam tak habis. Apa bilang saya.
Suka dengan Jepun ni eh? Okay.
Saya incline pada Jepun.
Okay.
You know why? Okay. Saya study, I did my degree in US. So I live in US for 4 years. I lived. The Americans are very individualistic. Very individualistic. That's why you see they don't care about me, about you. They just want their goals. Tengok macam big companies that, because they don't care about you. They just, you know, I want this to be done. Of course lah, there something is good also lah. Bukan kata totally not good, but and then there is less teamwork. Okay. So, but of course lah, benda ni dia berubah lah. Dia berubah. Macam ni dia kata is convergence. Eh. There is probably convergence lah. Convergence tu tak convergence. Convergence ni dia ada titik temu lah kan. Sekarang ni mungkin ada titik temu. Right? So this. Maybe you just want to read some of this and then get some ideas. Japan history. Jepun pun, dia belajar daripada luar. Dia pun belajar, bukan belajar daripada dalam. Tapi, yang hebatnya Jepun ni, dia boleh ubah tanpa dia rosakkan nilai dia. Nilai maksudnya, I mean, in term of hardworking, quality, and then dia punya culture. They keep to their culture. They don't destroy their culture. So that's some apa ni good things lah. Bukan semua bagus lah. I'm not saying semua bagus. Ni bagus ni. Paper ni kamu mungkin, kalau kamu baca ni mungkin dapat idea sikit lah. Boleh taruhkan dalam sistem pengurusan orang Jepun lah. Japanese management. Okay. Even China today, kalau kamu, if you read lah, kamu pernah dengar tak Haier TV, Haier, brand TV, brand kan? Pengasas Haier ni, dia telah gunakan apa ni, Konosuke Matsushita punya filosofi. Panasonic. That's why dia berjaya to become an electrical, good, you know, advanced electrical company because they copy from Japan. They copy Matsushita. Nampak tak? So the management system, Chinese company banyak yang actually dia cakap dia punya lah, tapi dia copy je. Korean pun sama. Korean pun tipu, apa ni, tiru daripada Jepun banyak. Banyak. Malaysian pun. Malaysian company. Tiru daripada Jepun. Banyak. Because Japanese have given the world management style dia memang, if you want to become not autocratic, Japanese. American autocratic. Japanese, they are very democratic. Of course lah, bukanlah kata 100%, tidaklah, tapi lebih demokratik daripada Western organization. Okay. So this is the thing that probably you kata tadi, apa ni, your hypothesis is banyak sangat choice sampai pada dia, inilah sistem yang tak sesuai dengan naluri dia lah. Pasal tak dapat naik pangkat, tak boleh dapat gaji besar. Pasal dia punya cara fikir dia macam tu lah. Dekat Jepun ramai orang yang middle income nya, dia tak ada yang kaya gila, miskin gila, tak ada. Pasal dia dia adalah equal distribution of wealth. Falsafah hidupnya adalah dia tak akan ambil lebih daripada yang dia patut ambil. Tapi American tidak. American. Malaysian company lagi teruk. Malaysian company yang apa ni, CEO lah. CEO pun, chairman pun kena buang kerja. Padahal apalah. Pasal, you know, gaji besar-besar tapi tak tahu apa yang berlaku dekat apa ni, Gemba tak tahu apa berlaku. Malu lah. You chairman, you CEO, you tak tahu Gemba. Gemba ni kat mana? Jangan jadi chairman lah. So problem kat Malaysian management system is that siapa ngampu dapat ni atas. Tapi tak ada knowledge, tak ada attitude, tak ada akhlak, mencuri, rasuah. Sama Western companies also berasuah. Kerja memang dia dapatlah gaji kat bawah tu, tapi dia punya rasuah tu Goldman Sachs. Dia rasuah dengan kerajaan. Ini saya rekod ke apa? Saya rekod. Goldman Sachs, MDB ni, dia rasuah je kerajaan kita. Gembat duit kerajaan, duit rakyat. Dia takkan tak makum salah. Kena pemerintah kita, kena kerajaan kita. Dua-dua pun sama, 2x5. Sama je, because dia pun nak curi duit kita. Kerajaan kita pun nak curi duit, sama je. This is management style. The ends justify the means. Nampak tak? So, so kita ni, Malaysian company, terlalu taksub dengan Western sampai kita terikut-ikut cara bisnes kita pun macam Western, British. Dalam tu kita campur dengan China, kaki tipu pula. Amat. Ini orang lama ni. Kamu pun orang lama juga kan. Memanglah kamu pada ni kerja apa ni, the career path of, but long term sustainability and also, you know, well being. Nampak?
So mainly about culture.
Ni.
Ha? Apa dia? Mainly is culture punya, environment culture lah.
Ha, culture. Kalau nak kata creativity, kamu tahu tak? Japanese company very creative. Compare dengan, of course, pada saya Jerman pun very creative. Jerman tipu ke? Jerman bergaduh dengan US. So, negara yang antara negara-negara yang hebat kat dunia ni, Jepun, Jerman. Of course US hebat, bukan saya kata US tak hebat, tapi penipu. UK, British, sama juga 2x5. Rakyat dia tipu, company dia tipu.
UK sebab.
Ha?
UK, Europe pun lebih kurang ke?
Europe lebih kurang. Ya, Europe lebih kurang, kecuali saya rasa Jerman. Jerman ni lain sikit lah. France sama penipu juga. So we look at, pada saya dah, bukan saya buat kajian lah, negara yang kalah perang dunia kedua tu adalah negara yang hebat, termasuk Jepun, Jerman, yang kena tindas. Turki kena tindas tapi hebat. Turki, Jerman, even apa ni, Japan for that matter, in terms of apa ni lah. Ni paper ni bagus lah, nanti saya hantar kat kamu. Ni saya dah download tadi. Saya glance through je, saya baca macam, tak apalah, kamu masuklah as part of apa, studying the Western management system approach kan. Akhir-akhir sekarang ni, Western company also dia terpaksa tiru Jepun juga. Macam TQM, Jepun. Lean, Jepun. Lean Jepun. Bukan Lean daripada Jepun. Western, tak. Okay. Apa ni, sustainability. Orang lain tegak-tegak je kejap. Toyota dah buat Mirai dah. Kat Jepun kalau kita tengok macam mana dia preserve environment, kilang sebelah kelapa apa ni sawah padi dekat dekat Nagoya tu Toyota. But when they produce and let effluent into the river, very clean water goes into the river. You see how dia punya business thinking is. Of course lah, dia datang kat Malaysia ni, dia buat pollution juga, dia sama juga dua kali. Pasal undang-undang kat sini
lain.
Lain lah, macam Singapura lah. Singapura, kat Singapura dia baik. Dia duduk kat sini, dia buang sampah.
Dia dah ada sampah.
Tapi apa, in the sense, adalah dia punya kebaikan lah di segi ni kan. Langsung terus apa ni lah. Tak buat kan. Kamu boleh faham kan flexible measuring, just in time, semua ni kan boleh faham kan?
Ya.
Yeah. Ha, dah biasa yeah. kan? Ha? So macam mana Mat? Kamu tak payah tulis pun tak apa Mat. Kamu sketch pun tak apa. Kamu just draw dia punya apa ni diagram ke, just tonton-tonton pun tak apa juga. Tak masalah. Kalau saya nak, memang nak dulu nak tulis, tunggu tulis tu. Memang lambat tu.
Itulah sebab 30 itu lambat
tu. Itu paragraf pertama pun tak perlu dah tu. Yang atas tu yang saya kata saya daripada Jepun. Tak payah tak payah. Itu tak payah
tu. Intonation tau. Okay, okay.
Kamu lama baca, cari thesis, master thesis mana-mana. Kau baca lah thesis yang apa, yang sesuai kan. Ataupun kamu Google boleh juga. Google kalau ada master thesis yang sesuai kan. Tapi jangan tiru lah. Yang tiru. Tiru ni bukan apa, bukan adat kita lah kan. Biar kita buat sendiri, apa orang kata susah sikit pun tak apa, tapi kita puas hati lah. Puas hati.
Macam master thesis kita nak dapat sebab dekat Google Scholar tu kebanyakan journal je saya jumpa.
Journal ada. Kita kena pergi ke apa website yang apa ni lah, website dekat specifically dekat dia punya library ke, dekat dia punya apa repository. Cuba kamu type dissertation abstract
itu,
international.
Itu hard copy ya.
Dissertation hard copy tak boleh lah kan. Itu memang tak boleh dapat lah kan. Tapi kadang-kadang ada rezeki boleh jumpa juga yang apa ni. Apa orang kata ini saya hantar yang ni lah, yang apa Japanese and Western Management Approach Convergence ni kan. Paper saya hantar email kat kamu. Saya cuba Google kan apa thesis kan. Okay, thesis. Okay, apa antara Japanese job satisfaction boleh. Sikit. Ni rasanya dekat ni paper eh. Ni master thesis ni. Ni nampak ni. Nampak?
Ya.
Ni worker job satisfaction in Japanese company in ni ada PDF. Saya cari satu minit, satu saat dia jumpa dah. Tapi tak banyak kot lah ni. Ni. Tapi di Vietnam ni okey lah. Vietnam ni kita bukan nak. Ni kan. Ni thesis ni. Dia kata thesis ataupun dia dah disingkatkan. Dia tak tahu lah. Download. Tapi tak download lah. Download. Download PDF. Oh, artikel teks. Dia mungkin dah summary kot. Ni master thesis. Level macam ni boleh lah. Level orang kata simple je dengan ni. Oh, pendek sangat thesis dia ni. Berapa muka surat lah? 19. Mungkin dah
20
ni macam cuak je. Ah, ni ada master thesis Diva Portal. Tapi jangan tirulah. Dia, saya bukan saya pantang. I mean it is not there's no integrity lah. And also
It's bukan not, dia kena terlitin ke? Kalau tiru memang terlitin.
Terminate. This is not apa, don't get into that lah. Saya rasa ada. You can survey. You can You can just Google mana yang dapat sebagai rujukan lah. Kita bukan nak dapatkan cara dia 100%, tidak. Tapi we get an idea. Yang penting if you refer more and more papers, you will get more ideas. Of course yang susah ni tepikan je. Bukan jangan, kalau dah benda disusahkan, tepi je. Tak apa. Nah, ini saya selalu advise orang. Walaupun tu bukan pas apa yang bagus lah. Tapi at master level tak apa, master. Tapi kalau ke PhD saya tak. PhD saya saya akan minta kamu kena buat, kena baca, kena cari. Tapi kalau master ni especially like macam master project kan. At the level lah, level of a project. That means bukan nak selesai masalah yang begitu susah, tidak perlu. Satu masalah yang agak, you know, just like just now I mentioned to you lah. I said that I want to know what are the reasons people switch. So one of them is you say choice. There are many other reasons. Even kalau choice pun, kita nak tanya management system. You can just leadership. You what kind of leadership do you like? What ni kan? If, sebenarnya maybe. Dia ni cakap dia choice, tapi sebenarnya jiwa dia tu sesuai untuk Japanese company. Contoh. Kalau kita tanya detail kan. Tanya do you like to do team work? Yes. But kita bila kita characterize, kita define Western management dengan Japanese management. This individual, this team work. But when they answer, they are answering here.
Yeah,
the jiwa dia punya opinion is towards Japanese, but they are working in American company.
Okay.
So survey bagus. Survey, you can ask which company you work, and then you can ask the characteristics, and you boleh relate kan? Nampak tak? Dia kita boleh apa ni, cross check lah, cross check. You ni ini betul ke ni?
Okay. So saya antara saya fikir. Sebab saya takut kalau interview ada benda yang dia orang tak nak cakap lah. Kalau survey tu dia pun boleh letak
sebab orang lah. So strateginya mungkin apa ni, buat a small survey je lah apa yang ni kan. Ataupun just survey je, you punya study survey je. Survey semua orang. Survey lah semua orang. Lepas tu daripada tu buat statistic analysis, that's it. Tak payah nak apa nak
interview lagi
lah. Tak payah. Maksudnya you nak tahu apakah faktor-faktor yang menyebabkan orang tukar kerja daripada Jepun ke tidak Jepun ataupun kepada non-Japanese to Japanese. So either way also kita akan consider. So we want to look at the factors influencing. Factors. Cuba temukan waktu this. Factors influencing career ataupun mid career lah, mid career change between Japanese and non-Japanese companies. Lebih kurang macam tu lah. Tapi kau boleh ubah sikit lah kalau kamu nak ubah. Nampak? Nampak? Mungkin boleh lah. Mungkin boleh ubah nanti. Tapi saya macam terfikir factors influencing mid-career change of job lah. Change of job between Japanese and non-Japanese companies. But title ni tak apa, title boleh ubah dia. Tapi tu betul, nampak tak ni kalau saya sebut je ni, factors influencing mid-career job change. Mid-career job change. Between Japanese and non-Japanese. Nampak tak? Jadi Japanese management system ni macam ni. Non-Japanese nya ni macam Western ke Malaysia macam ni. So why they switch? They want higher pay. They want higher position. They're not satisfied. Why they not satisfied? So juga macam turutan survey lah. Jadi kamu tengok dia punya, yang mungkin ada orang dah pernah buat lah ni, job satisfaction lah basically. Tapi kamu buat apa ni, twist kepada job change. Tapi it's actually job satisfaction kan? Dia sebenarnya berkaitan dengan job satisfaction, tapi kita twist kepada job change punya situation lah. Okay. Ni macam bagi answer je, bukan bagi answer, macam bagi
guidance ni, bagus kan guidance ni.
Tak kamu faham tak apa saya sebut ni? Kamu faham tak apa yang saya maknanya guide title?
Faham.
Jadi bila baca ke ataupun refer pada journal atau thesis lah, tengok thesis, ada tak thesis yang keywordnya mungkin job satisfaction, job change, factors for change, macam tu lah. Saya boleh buat research ni, tapi jadi saya punya master thesis lah nanti.
Okay. Senang lah awak. Ha? Senang lah.
Jadi sudah balik lah. Boleh je.
Okay, factor of change.
Tak apa lah, pelan-pelan lah. Saya apa ni, okay. Macam saya discuss dengan Mazlan. Mazlan sudah saya lagi satu kan.
Ya, yeah, ya.
Yeah. Dia macam nampak lagi clear lah. Kamu belum clear lagi ni. Saya nak bantu kamu supaya nampak lebih clear sikit.
Okay.
Saya bantu supaya nampak clear. Tak apa. Ambil masa pun tak apa. Yang penting macam Jepun kan. Jepun kan dia bila dia bincang benda yang asas kan, planning tu kan. Kan dia bincang lama kan? Bincang planning buat ni kan? Dia tak tahu buat kan?
Ya.
Yeah. Jadi kita sekarang ni. Jadi kita sebenarnya nak dia punya asas tu betul. Asas tu betul. Lepas tu dia punya method tu dia betul. Bila dah betul, kita collect data, settle lah. Kita collect data, kita analyze, settle. Tapi pasal kita dah fikir masak dia punya problem and also dia punya planning. So we spend a lot of time trying to articulate. Articulate mean kita nak perjelaskan lagi. Ha? Okay, Pak Mat. Dah sejam juga ni duduk buat
apa. Dekat-dekat. Okay. Terima kasih, Pak. So minggu depan, okay, saya cuba continue yang writing tu lah.
Writing dengan apa yang saya sebut tadi ni lah. Bukan writing tu je. Writing boleh. Tapi tengok struktur keseluruhan je. Buat mind map. Untuk keseluruhan punya apa ni problem dia. Mind map lah, macam mind map. Okay. Teori je. Macam dia punya ni. Ha? Okay. Alright. Ada apa soalan?
So okay.
Kamu kat rumah kat mana?
Kat rumah.
Kat rumah?
Kat rumah. Hari tu je dia panggil office hari ni kat rumah. So Prof expect saya berapa page untuk saya writing. Sebab dia.
Untuk introduction ni dengan chapter 1 lah eh. Chapter 1, chapter 2 lah.
Chapter 2
at least kalau kamu dapat tulis by end of this semester lah eh. At least 15 pages.
Okay.
Introduction chapter 1 kurang-kurang 5-8 muka surat. Tapi boleh tambah lagi tau. Ni maknanya for this semester maybe I need a 20 page report lah at least. Supaya saya boleh bagi markah penilaian kan.
Mazlan tunggu pula kan.
Eh tak, Mazlan dia Isnin.
Oh, dia Isnin. Oh, dia tukar dah sikit dulu.
Dia dah tukar schedule. Hari Jumaat kamu je dengan ada seorang lagi si apa engineer Zaini tu yang senior.
Oh. Oh, Zaini tu. Okey.
Kenal. Eh, kenal dia.
Ada hari tu masuk satu kelas kot.
Ingat. Ha, dia consultant tu.
Dia dah nak habis dah tu. Dia second year lah.
Ah, dia second year dah nak habis.
Okey, okey.
Okey lah. Okey. Jadi kalau apa-apa mesej jelah saya kalau apa-apa yang apa ni stuck ke apa ke saya boleh
okey
bantukan juga
ha? Okey faham okey nasib bos
so I'll see you next week lah insyaallah kalau tak ada okay. Apa-apa so, tak ada apa-apa mesej jelah saya okey mana okey
okey terima kasih bos
okey right assalamualaikum.